Hello students, welcome to my class. Today I am going to take your EBS subject. In that we are going to see lesson number 1 about myself. Before starting to our lesson, they have given your warm up. So first we'll do the warm up exercise. Paste a photograph of you as a baby in the first box. Paste another photograph of yours taken recently in the second box. What changes do you see in yourself as you grow? See here students, when I was a baby, when you were a small baby, that photograph you have to stick here. And now how you are looking, that recent photograph you have to stick in this box. Okay students, and you have to write here whatever the changes you can see in both the photographs. Now, as we grow older, different parts of our body also grow. Yes, students, when we were small, our body parts are also small. Now we are growing day by day, right? So when we grow, our body parts also grow. In this lesson, what we are going to see? Parts of the body and sense organs. What are the parts of the body? Look at your friends in the class. Does everyone look the same? See? They have given some images here. Look at the friends in your class. Suppose these are your friends. Does everyone look the same? No. Some of you are tall while some are short. You can see this. He is taller than all, right? Some have curly heads. See, this girl is having curly hair. You can see here. And others may have straight hair. This girl is having straight hair. This girl is also having straight hair, right? So everyone does not look same. Now, parts of the body. What are the parts of the body? Our body has three main parts. Which are the three main parts? Head, trunk and limb. This is the trunk and these are limbs. Now see, in head, which parts are included? Hair, forehead, eyes, nose, ears, mouth, cheeks and chin are present in and around the head area. In this head area, how many parts are included? Which are they? Hair, this is forehead, eyes, nose, ears, mouth, cheeks and chin. These body parts are included in our head area. Okay, now trunk. Now what is trunk? Chest in front, the back, the shoulders and the stomach form the trunk. What is trunk? This is chest and the back portion. In the front and the back, shoulders, stomach are form trunk. These are all called trunk. The head is attached to the trunk by neck. You can see here, this trunk is attached to head by the neck, right? Now limbs. Now what are limbs? Arms from the shoulder to the fingers. See, you can see here, from shoulders to fingers form the upper limbs. This is called upper limbs, from shoulders to fingers. We use hands to touch, feel and hold things. For what purpose we use our hands? To touch, to feel and to hold things. And this is called upper limbs, from shoulder to fingers. Legs from the hips to the toes form the lower limbs. Now what they are saying? From legs from the hips, here from hips to toes, from hips to toes form the lower limb. This is called lower limb. We use our legs to walk, run and jump. Yes, we all use our legs for walking, running, jumping, right? So these are called lower limb. From hips to toes, lower limb, and from shoulders to fingers is upper limb. And the chest part in front and back, shoulders and stomach is called trunk. So which are the main three parts? Head, trunk and limbs. Head, trunk and limbs. Now we are going to see sense organs. What are sense organs? You all know there are 5 sense organs. Yes, in the earlier class also we have learnt about sense organs. You can see here, sense organs. The eyes, ears, nose, skin and tongue are are sense organs. Eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin. These sense organs help us to see, hear, smell, touch and taste respectively. These all sense organs help us to see, hear, smell, touch and taste respectively. Now see how eyes are helping us. Eyes help us to see things around us. The eyelids and eyelashes protect the eyes. From eyes, what we can do? We can see the things around us, right? These are the eyelids. Yes, and eyelashes. These are the eyelashes. And what they do? They protect our eyes. They protect our eyes. Now, ears. How ears helps us? Ears helps us to hear sounds. We enjoy hearing some sounds like music and the chirping of a bird. Ears help us to hear like good music when you hear some sound. Yes, which sense organ help us? Ears helps us, right? Chirping of a bird, sounds like music. And the next one is nose. How nose helps us? Nose helps us to smell. We can smell the sweet scent of a flower as well as the bad smell from a garbage dump with the help of nose. What do nose do? Nose help us to smell sweet scent of a flower. Yes, sweet smell also and the bad smell also that comes from garbage. Yes, from garbage dump. It tells us, the nose tells us it is a bad smell or a good smell. Then skin help us to feel the things around us. The skin allows us to know whether these things are hot, cold, rough, smooth, hard or soft. Now whenever we touch something, now suppose this pencil is there. If I touch this pencil, this is little bit hard, right? Hard. And suppose I'll touch any teddy bear, I'll suppose soft toy teddy bear, if I touch teddy bear, how it is? It is very soft. So how you know that it is soft or rough? By touching it. Skin tells us that it is soft or rough or hot or cold. When your mother gives you a glass of a milk, how do you come to know that it is hot or cold? When you touch that glass, right? Now, tongue. The tongue helps us to taste different food items. Whenever you put something in your mouth, which sense organ helps you to tell that it is sweet, it is sour, yes, it is tangy? Tongue helps us to tell the taste. Now see here students, did you know tongue not only helps us to taste something but also it helps in speech? Yes, it helps in our speech. Whatever we speak, it is the help of the tongue. We have to observe that when we speak, our tongue also go ups and downs. Okay. Now, taking care of your sense organ. Now, how we can take care of our sense organ? Now, first we are going to see eyes. Wash your eyes with clean and cool water. We have to wash our eyes with clean and cool water every day. Do not rub your eye if there is dirt in it. If anything goes in your eyes, do not rub it. Do not put or place sharp and pointed objects in and around the eyes. We should not put any sharp thing. Like this pencil is in my hand. Okay, this point is also sharp. Sometimes you play with the pencil. Yes, so you should not play with the pencil or this type of sharp object around the eyes. Do not watch television for long time. We should not watch television also for long time. You love to watch TV, I know, but it will affect our eyes, right? So you can watch for 1 hour, 1 hour, 1.5 hour, it's fine, but not more than that. Now how to take care of ears? Do not put any object like pencil or pin into your ears. We should not put anything in our ears. Okay, like pencil or pin, nothing. No, not a single object you will put in your ears. Do not use a stick or a pin to clean your eyes. You should not use cotton bud also to clean our ears, right? That is also harmful for our ears. Avoid listening to loud music, and we should not listen loud music. We should not hear loud music. It will also affect our ears. It is not good for your ears. Okay. Now, nose. Do not put dirty or sharp objects into your nose. We should not put any sharp object neither in your eyes, neither in your ears or nose. We should not put any sharp objects into your nose. Clean your nose while bathing. When you take bath, that time you have to clean your nose. Now, how to take care of tongue? Clean your tongue regularly when you brush your teeth. When you brush your teeth, you should clean your tongue also. Then, skin. Have a bath every day to keep your skin clean. You have to take bath every day. Wash your hands before eating a meal. You should wash your hands before and after eating a meal. Whenever you sit for eating, you have to wash your hands. And after eating also, you have to wash your hands with soap and water. And wash your hands after using the toilet. Whenever you use toilet, you should wash your hands again with soap and water. Then, I hope students, you all have understood in this lesson what we have seen about my body and sense organs: ears, nose, eyes, tongue and skin. Did you know cat, lion and tiger cannot taste sweet? They cannot taste sweet things. Okay, they don't know what is the taste of sweets thing or what is the taste of sweets. Now we are going to evaluate things you know. Which sense organ would you use to do the following? Choose the correct word from the box and fill in the blanks. We have to choose the word from this box. To watch a rainbow, which sense organ we are going to use? Eyes. To smell a jasmine flower, which sense organ we are going to use? Nose. To taste a piece of chocolate? Tongue. To hear the ringing bell? Ears. To feel how hot something is? Skin. Now, strike out the incorrect word. Whichever the word is incorrect, we have to strike out that. Eyes, legs are one of our sense organs. Which is our sense organ? Eyes. So, legs is the incorrect one. So, I'm going to cross it. Second one is, we use our skin, nose, to feel things. We use our skin. So, nose is the incorrect one. The shoulder, hip is a part of our upper limbs. Shoulder is the part of our upper limb, so hip is the incorrect one. Our nose, tongue help us to smell things. Nose helps us to smell things, so tongue is the incorrect one. Eyelashes, ears protect our eyes. Eyelashes, ears protect our eyes. Eyelashes, so ear is the incorrect one. The head includes the hair or shoulder. The head includes hair. So, shoulder is the incorrect one. Now, state true or false. We have two pairs of limbs. We have two pairs of limbs. Yes, it is true or false? True. So, we are going to write here spelling of true. We do not change as we grow older. True or false? False. We change when we grow older, right? So, false. Then, eyelids and eyelashes protect the eye? Yes. So, true. The neck joins the head to the trunk? Yes. True. We should avoid listening to loud sounds to protect our skin? False. Now, the following are some regular activities we do. Fill in the boxes with the correct letters to find out the organs we use in those activities. Watching television. For watching television, which sense organ we are going to use? Eyes. So E is already written. Y-E-S. Eyes. Touching ice cubes. Which sense organ we are going to use? Skin. Then smelling a pizza. We smell with our nose. So N-O-S-E. Nose. Tasting ice cream. Tongue. T-O-N-G-U-E. Listening to music, ears, E-A-R-S, ears. Now, draw lines to match correctly. Now, we have to draw a line to match correctly. Whenever you do this exercise, you have to use scale. Hands and legs are limbs. Eyes, nose and tongue are sense organs. Head, trunk, limbs. These are main body parts. These are the three main body parts. Now, answer in a word or two. Which sense organ helps in speech? Which sense organ helps in speech? Tongue. T-O. N-G-U-E. Which sense organ helps us to see things around us? Eyes. So, E-Y-E-S, eyes. Which organ is used to hear sounds? Ears. E-A-R-S, ears. Answer in sentence. This question answer I am going to give you in your notebook. Now, match the organs with their senses. These are organs and these are senses. We have to match it. First one is eyes. From eyes, we can see. So, we are going to match it. For this activity also, you are going to use scale. Nose. Nose helps us to smell. Then ears. Ears helps us to hear. Then tongue. Tongue helps us to taste. Then skin. Skin helps us to touch. Okay, students, I hope you all have understood this lesson. Thank you. See you in the next class. Bye. Take care.